Dear foreign students, my name is Zhang Hong, Associate Dean of the School of Architecture at Southeast University, also known as SU Arch. Today, I'm delighted to take this opportunity to provide you a brief introduction of our school. Established in 1927, SU Arch is the origin of modern architecture education in China. During the past 93 years, it has been continuously in the leading position of architectural education in China and exerted an important influence in the world. In SU Arch, we hold the idea that the teaching, learning, and research should focus on the real-world problems for the real people. In this school, we aim to educate the leading professionals for the world and for the future. The rapid urbanization in China gave us valuable opportunities to study, to practice, to think, and to educate. More than 8,000 outstanding talents in these fields have been trained here, including the first Pritzker Architecture Prize winner in China, including 12 academicians of the Chinese Academy of Science and the Chinese Academy of Engineering, nearly half of the total number in these fields. Our alumni are making extraordinary contributions to the development and the construction in China. In SU Arch, we value the potential of design, which can substantially and creatively influence the built environment and the human society. The bachelor program in SU Arch includes architecture, urban planning, and landscape architecture. We offer professional degree for Bachelor of Architecture and Bachelor of Engineering for Urban Planning and Landscape Architecture. The curriculum for undergraduate is constructed on the commonalities of design culture, historical awareness, and technical capability. The junior share the common basis and the senior have advanced interdisciplinary courses within this system. The students need to have a macro perspective of decision-making, balanced ability, and fresh creativity. Our graduate education upholds the value of this school, including design-centered, practice-oriented, research-integrated, and learning by doing. We also encourage the interdisciplinary conversation and cooperation, which we believe is the only way to bring fundamental innovations of the new series, methods, and technologies. For each discipline in SU Arch, we offer professional or academic degree at master and doctor's level. In SU Arch, we embrace the top students, professionals, and researchers from all over the world who can achieve a new vision that one single country cannot acquire. Today, our school has the most complete discipline structure, strong and diverse faculty. We have a tight connection with many international first-class universities, a number of foreign professors, and dozens of English courses and studios, international students' exchanges, teaching activities, and research cooperation have become our daily life. If you wish to become an architect, an urban planner, or a landscape architect, welcome to SU Arch, and I'm looking forward to meeting you in our school one day in the near future. Thank you very much.
这样就可以了，这样就可以了。
Dear friends and the first-time students, it's a great honor for me to introduce our school to you. I'm Shali, currently the Executive Vice Dean of the School of Civil Engineering. In the following few minutes, I will talk about our school and our research strengths. We have a history started in 1923 when Professor Mao Yisheng came back from USA and started the program. In 1950, we have a national reform, and the teaching has been completely restructured. Our school has been tasked to write the first textbook about the design of reinforced concrete structure in China. It also developed the first teaching program of industry of civil structures. Since then, we have taught many generation students who have been working in mega project and in key engineering sectors in civil engineering. In 1997, the school has been officially founded. It was a restructure of several research disciplines and become the current form. Ever since then, we have been a continuous developing trend. So in the National Discipline Assessment, when we first joined in 2004, we were rated at 6. But over the last 20 years or so, we have been continually climb up to first tier in 2017. Here you can see the faces of our faculties. In total, we have 204 staff members, and 67 of them are professors. Most of them have doctorate degree in the top university in China or from overseas. Nearly all of them have been aboard to study or to work for a certain time. And recent years, we have been awarded the National 111 program, which is an international collaborative program to attract international leading expertise to join and work with us. Currently, while this program is currently supporting more than 10 overseas professors, some of them are academicians from United States, the Great Britain, and Switzerland to come to our university. Although we are a research-focused developing, we value teaching very much, so we have a long history to developing textbooks, not only for us, but also for students from other countries. We also have a good tradition to integrate the current research with teaching. So this is how we can train our students' innovation and also the research capabilities from their undergraduate times. As evidence, we have been awarded in the last four rounds the National Award for Teaching Excellence. It's basically a national evaluation or national competition from different universities to see what's your teaching philosophy and how you implement them in your program. For undergrad students, we encourage them to study abroad for a certain period. We have signed agreement with a number of world-leading universities, including University of Illinois, National University of Singapore, and many of them. So currently, our students can go abroad and study one semester or participate in international competitions. We hope in the next few years, we can increase the rate, the percentage of undergraduates go abroad to 50%. For our students and academic staff, they basically constantly go abroad to join for research collaborations and also just for exchange. So in Nanjing at Southeast Universities, constantly we have invited the world's leading scholars to come over and deliver lectures. And also our staff members are constantly present in the national conference organized in China and also overseas. Based on our research strengths, we also organize and leading the international conference in China, also within our campus. For students who may be interested in joining us, here is a list of programs we are teaching. For undergraduates, we have five majors. They are civil engineering, construction management, engineering mechanics, water engineering, and intelligent construction. And also we have master program in three main areas. They are civil engineering, engineering mechanics, management science, and engineering. So for these three master programs, we have developed a completely English taught program. That means overseas students can come over and study here in English. On top of them, we have some special program developed for domestic and international students. One of them is the One Belt and One Road Master Program. It's one of the six programs approved by the national government. What they do is they come over to study courses in the first year, and the second year they go back to their home countries and continue their work. At the end of the second year, we write a thesis and assessed. Well, after they complete this assessment, they will be awarded a master's degree. The second one I want to introduce is the double degree master program in civil engineering, which is joint developed by Monash and us. So students who participate the courses will be automatically awarded two master degrees. To make students feel at home when they study in China, we have a list of activities to integrate them to study and work with our students, and also we bring them out to engineering site so they have first-hand engineering experience. That's all about our school. The following is our research strengths. Over the past 20 years, we have established a few national or the Ministry of Education funded research platforms. They basically are research clusters about certain areas. Roughly speaking, we can group our current research in five key areas. The first one is high performance engineering materials. As you can imagine, by improving the material performance, we can have better and safer structures. And the second one is about the fundamental theory for concrete and pre-stressed concrete structures. And on top of them, we are specialized areas about high performance structure and its durability. And also we're working on how structure perform against disasters, and we have the theories and the structure monitoring to mitigate its impact. The last one is about industrialized building and intelligent construction, which is integration of the current communication technology, computer science, and automation with civil engineering to make the construction and the structures more human friendly. A few words about each of these areas. For high performance engineering materials, we're working on from the molecular structures to material properties, and also we combine our research developments with real projects. So our materials, the civil engineering material developed by our faculties, has been applied to the mega project in China, including the Three Gorge Dam, the Daya One nuclear power station, which is showing the research has a real impact on our industry. The second main research area is the fundamental theories for concrete and the pre-stressed concrete. This is our strength for the last few decades. We're working on how complicated structures sustain loading, and we work on how we can build them. So you can see some of the results we were doing. We can not only build our normal life structures, we can also have very interesting special structures. For example, the FAST project is the 500 meter in diameter telescope we developed to receive signals from outer space. And the third research area is the fundamentals and the technology for high performance structures and its durability. As you know, you may know in China, in the last few decades, we have a few mega projects. For example, the construction we built around South Sea of China, they are actually on reef materials. We also have a number of bridges which are more than 1,000 meters. So for these structures, they are not so easy to be built up based on our daily technology. We need to design not only the materials and structures, and then also the construction process to build them up. And of course, we want them to be there for a really long time. So this is how we study from the material, from the structures, trying to improve the system performance and durability. The fourth one is actually about safety. There are times we have natural disasters, for example, earthquake, and sometimes we fail fires. The structure needs to stay safe in these disasters, and if not, at least people can escape from them in good time. So this is a research, important research thing within the school. So we have developing numerical simulation technology, we have experiments, and we also have health monitoring systems just to get ready or prepared for disasters and mitigate its impact. The last research areas is the industrialized building and the intelligent constructions. Actually, in the past 10 years, the construction sectors has been completely reformed. Nowadays, we don't really cast in place concrete. We actually have the structures of the members built in factory and bring them up to the construction site and just connect them up. So in this technology, it's called the industrialized building. So over the last 10 years, our school has been really incorporate with the industry to pushing the frontiers of this research. More recently, we are integrate communication technology, big data, computer science, so that we can have a new method of build structures. For example, now we can do the 3D printing of structures, and also we can have integrated equipment to monitoring and control the structure's performance, and also we can develop a completely BIM building information management system based the construction site for a project management. We're also working on distributed and the systems so we can monitor the construction and the long term performance of infrastructures. For all these five research areas, We are doing very fundamental and high quality research, and we are applying them to industry projects. And our contribution has been recognized in the national and international level. And here are a few photos showing our faculty members actually won the national award and are present at the site. And this is a really great honor for us. So that's all a very quick introduction to ourselves and also our research. We hope to see you soon in Nanjing to study and doing research with us. Thank you.
Okay, it's a big pleasure for me to introduce the School of Transportation at Southeast University to you. My name is Zhiyuan Liu. I'm the Vice Dean on International Affairs in School of Transportation. So let's first talk about where we are, the location of Southeast University. You can see from this slide that the Jiangsu province is located in the east coast of China. We are very close to Shanghai city. Okay, Nanjing is the capital of Jiangsu province, and our university is located in the heart of Nanjing city. You can see from the landscape pictures in this slide that Nanjing is a very, very beautiful city. The history of our university can date back to 1921. So we are one of the oldest universities in China. We have a history of about 100 years. And the university has been renamed for several times in the history. For example, in 1928, the university is renamed as a National Central University. At that time, Nanjing is the capital of the whole country. And this university is a leading university in the whole Asia area. For the disciplines in School of Transportation, you can see that in the red color, we have four first-tier disciplines, and we have several second-tier disciplines in each first-tier discipline. So what is the difference between first-tier and second-tier discipline? Second-tier discipline actually is like the branches of the first-tier discipline. In the school, the main body of the disciplines is transportation engineering. We have transportation planning and management, highway and railway engineering. We call operations engineering, traffic information engineering and control, as well as traffic safety. The first tier discipline, transportation engineering, has a top rank in China. We are one of the leading schools in China, and also we are one of the largest. You can see that from the ranking in China. Actually, in China, there's only one official ranking, which is conducted by the Ministry of Education every 5 years. You can see that for the first round of ranking, the School of Transportation, Southeast University, ranked fifth. And as the time goes by, with our efforts, our ranking has gradually improved. And from 2012 until now, we are the leading school in China. This slide shows you the institutes and the research center. It just gives you a snapshot of the research groups in our school. You can see that from the name of the institutes, our school covers almost every sub-area of transportation studies, transportation engineering, and research. Okay, this slide shows you the student team in School of Transportation. You can see from here that we totally have 11 departments, 7 types of bachelor degree, and 2 types of PhD degree. The current undergraduate student number is more than 1,300, and we have another team of graduate students, which is slightly more than 1,200. So with such a big team of students, we can cover all kinds of research and lab areas. And in the school, from the last 10 years, we gradually put a lot of efforts into international cooperation. You can see that we have several double degrees and also some kind of collaboration education training with international leading schools. For example, we are one of the first joint degree in China. This joint degree is Monash University and the Southeast University Joint Graduate School. It's a 1+1 master degree. If you apply for this degree in Southeast University, you will have one master degree from Southeast University and another master degree from Monash University at Australia. And our school also established several 3+X or 4+X joint graduate degree program with leading international schools. For example, Wisconsin Medicine and France University of Rhode Bridge and other very famous universities. So with the support from the Belt and Road Initiative, we warmly welcome you to apply for this kind of joint degree with Southeast University, and we have very good scholarship support. This slide shows you the alumni of our school. The alumni trained in school transportation now are leaders in each different area of transportation in China and abroad. For example, the current Vice Minister of Ministry of Transport, Mr. Liu Xiaoming, is an alumni of the school. And another Vice Minister, Mr. Huang Wei, is our alumni and he is our previous dean. Several other alumni are leaders in the transportation planning, transportation infrastructure, and other transportation involved areas. So if you come to this school, I believe that you have a very strong background in China and several other countries in this area, transportation. Okay, from this slide, you can see that our alumni who are top leading engineers in transportation area at China, they are doing the most strongest engineering project in China. For example, in the last 5 years, the largest transportation project in China is known as Hong Kong Zhuhai Macau Bridge Project. And the most challenging engineering topic is conducted by our alumni, who is the chief engineer, who is Mr. Liu Linming. This slide shows you where we are, and this is our new building at Julonghu Campus. So Julonghu Campus is in the south part of Nanjing City. If you come to this campus, you can see that the currently tallest building is School of Transportation. You may see it's a twin building, and behind us is a School of Civil Engineering. So if you come to this school, you will basically stay in this building together with the other 2,000 students and the professors. This is an inside snapshot of our building. You can see that we have spent a lot of effort in the cultural development and all kinds of lab and meeting conference facilities. So basically, the school has provided the leading working and research environment for our students. We welcome you to come to us and stay together in this new building with us. In our school transportation, we also have another building, which is a lab facilities. So in this lab building, we have the top tier research facilities. For example, we have developed the first transportation big data computing and big data analytic platform in China, and now it's in our lab building, work focused on the big data analysis. From the second slide, you can see that in this platform, we have stored all kinds of data which is related to the transport big data analysis. So if you come to us, you will have the best environment and support to pinpoint real research on the big data analysis. We use artificial intelligence, we use machine learning and all kinds of advanced technology to help you polish your research on transportation engineering. Okay, we also have some big body. You can see that here we have a driving simulator. The size of this big guy is about 4 times larger than a sedan car. In China, only 2 universities have this big body. One is our university, another one is actually in Tongji University and Shanghai. This is a very advanced facility for your research. If you are working on traffic safety, traffic control, and travel behavior analysis, you can actually enter this driving simulator and do your simulation there. You can see from this slide that we are working on several different projects to use this driving simulator on our driving analysis. And this one actually has developed several different driving environments, gives you all kinds of complex driving situations to help you improve your research. Okay, so from this page, you can see that the driving simulator has provided very rich situations for your research. If you are doing some kind of traffic safety research, it provides you with all kinds of environments to do your test. And another big guy is on the pavement engineering. We have this paved testing facility. In China, only 3 universities has this big body. One is in Southeast University, and one is in Chang'an University. The last one is in Beijing Jiao Tong University. So it provides the very good research environment for our students in pavement engineering discipline to work on their research topic. Okay, so from here, I have finished my introduction to you on school transportation. We hope that we can see you in future in the school, in our beautiful campus. If you have any question to us, please feel free to contact us by sending us emails or call us directly. Thank you.